Hey, so it's me, Josephine. I'm making another video blog for you this week. So I've been getting some comments not only on here, but also in some of my classes at school that have been suggesting that maybe I'm not that smart. And I wouldn't really argue with that because I don't really get high grades in school, but I don't really think that that's important. Like, I know what you need to know about, which is how to be popular and how to be gorgeous and how to get rich. And those are really all the things you need to know in the world. Because really what's important in the world is that lots of people talk about you. And who do people talk about? People don't talk about smart people. They talk about people who are rich, good-looking, and popular. Like, take, for example, Paris Hilton. Now, I'm not gonna lie, Paris Hilton, maybe not that smart, but everybody loves to talk about her. But nobody likes to talk about smart people, like that Russian guy who wrote that really big long book, or that other Russian guy who died because somebody threw a pickaxe at his head. Kind of like how some people throw brooms at people's faces. Nobody ever talks about those people, even though they were probably smart. So, what is better? Being smart and have everybody forget you, or be popular and gorgeous and have everybody love you? Obviously, be popular and gorgeous and have everybody love you. So I've never thought in the past that it was important for me to get smart. But then I realized something. See, I've told you already, one of my goals is to be on a reality show and then I'll get famous from that. And I always thought that I only needed to be gorgeous to get on a reality show. And then I realized, if I want to do well on the reality show, I probably need to be smart too. Because in a lot of shows they put in like challenges that test your intelligence. And as it is right now, I probably wouldn't do very well in those challenges. So, I've decided I need to get smart. So, I had to think for a long time about how to do that, and I came up with an idea. I'm going to read the dictionary. Every day, I'll open it up to a few different words, and I'll figure out what the word means, and I'll use it in a sentence throughout the day. And I didn't actually have a dictionary because when I need to know what a word means, I just ask a fugly person who is smart. Because, I mean, there are fugly people who are dumb, but a smart fugly person. And they usually give me the answer, like Little Miss Sweeney Todd. She knows every freaking word on the planet. Like, the other day, she used the word correlation. That's a big word. Nobody needs to know what that means. So I just ask her, and sometimes she's mean, but a lot of times she gives me the word. So I found a dictionary in my mom's room, though, and I brought it here right now. Take a look.
I'd like to help you.
Thank you, paperback Oxford, for 100 years of Canadian publishing. Look. That's a lot of years of Canadian publishing. That's pretty crazy. Anyways, I'm going to demonstrate to you right now my plan. So I'm going to open it up. And then I'm going to pick a random word, and I'm going to figure out what it means, and I'm going to use it in a sentence for you.
You don't need to be caught, Lord. Just keep yourself free.
Roof iron. A violent, lawless person. So, you don't have any laws, therefore, you're a roofian. So it's like an insult. I don't know if I like that. I'm trying another one.
Just drop off the key and get yourself free.
Drag strip. N a mare. A straight stretch of road built and used for drag races.
And would you please explain about
the 50 ways? We dragged something along the drag. What the hell's a drag race anyway? Okay, that word sucked, but find another word.
Then she kissed me, and I realized she probably was right. There must be 50 ways.
Hellenism. Is that about a girl named Helen?
50 ways to leave your lover.
Greek character or culture. Ancient. Two, the study or imitation of Greek culture. So, I wrote a story about ancient Greece, and I named one of the characters Hellenism. It's like the modern name Helen, but it's more Greek. Hellenism. Got it. Okay, so all I have to do now is use the words drag strip, Hellenism, and Ruffian in a sentence today, and then I will be on my way to being smart. And if I just do the same thing for a few words every day, I will get really smart, really fast, and I can be on a reality show, and I can do well on the reality show, and I can get famous and rich, and everybody will love about me and talk about me, and I will be much, much cooler than some weird Russian guy who is dating a girl with a unibrow. That's gross. Okay, anyways, that's been like 6.5 minutes, and I know you guys probably want more because I know I'm really great and you love to watch my videos. I know everybody loves my videos, but I gotta go. I have to go to a party, and I have to go use the word drag strip at a party. So I'll talk to you guys next week, and until then, have fun, and I will be getting smarter, so I'll be much, much more intelligent next time I talk to you, but I will still be just as hot and just as rich. I forgot to blow it, because I'm not very smart.